Recording. What's happening, guys? You're in the garage. We're just in practice today, and we're just wrestling and we're working on stuff. Today we're gonna have an offensive day, but before we kind of get into the whole offensive system, it's important to like make sure you identify a couple of like minor tweaks or different things that you want to work on. Christopher today is working on claw ride. Specifically, he wants me to kind of put pressure on and get this claw ride on and give him different types of looks, and then we'll probably jump into kind of some more technical coaching as we go. So you guys are in the garage, just enjoy and watch in. So I'm gonna go probably about 80%. To start, I'm just gonna give you a good look and make sure you have, you know, different types of looks too. So, but the main thing is you're talking about this kind of claw, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What about your near side claw? Has anybody done that?
Not really.
Just cross claw to you.
Yeah.
Okay. Ready? Go. See how you start to move your hips away? Mm-hmm. I can't run over that side now. Here. Change over to this hip. Good. Yep. Change over becomes really important. Let me stick my knee pad on. Now, differences. One is if your hips come out to the right, right here, then you want to go all towards my legs. Yeah, you want to just stay focused towards my legs. I'm going to try to, yeah, and I can't. If you stay on my legs like that, you're going to win there. Okay. Versus the other side, here, okay, you would actually, if you jumped your hips out the other side, and you want to make sure you block that, like block my leg, go back again. You really want to make sure you push this down. You push that down, pops your legs out. Now, catch bottom wrist. Yeah, and if you can, even just, yeah, I mean, hook it the best you can. And then have that leg here. Okay? Thing you want to be careful of is if you don't hook this, okay, and you just focus on my legs, okay, I'm gonna go back to this vertical position here, okay, and now his job is gonna be different. Does that make sense? Okay. So let's go back to an 80% look. Go. Big wide legs. There, now cross field. So again, vertical, Chipotle, that has a vertical, okay? Understanding, like, when I go to that defense, I really actually, you're just going like this, you're just turning, so you're kind of choking yourself a little bit. You need to make sure you make that hip shift. See how I switch my hip down? Now I get deep. Now I make sure when I turn, it definitely didn't happen. Okay? And I'm deep, like, so just do that little hip exchange one time. It'll make a big difference for you. So if you're here, you know, I got vertical position, do a big hip change there. Yeah, and as you do that, this pushes the elbow down deeper so that way, yeah, so now that can go up. Yeah. Just remember this, that one pushes, but your other one just goes up. It doesn't hang on. Here, pushes. Good. See if it hangs on. I'll get it to hang on. Don't hang on with this. So this one just goes elbow up. So elbow up this way. Yep. There. Yeah. But don't hang on with this. Yeah. Oh, shoot. Here. Okay. Hand exchange. Now. Elbow up, just like this. Okay, I don't do this. Elbow up. Here, up. Here. Yeah. You got the technique right. Only thing you need to do different is the hip change. Okay. So. top a little bit. Just one more look. So you have my foot. You already have it. Now walk your hips out. There. Now you can just elevate. No, keep that. Keep that. Keep that. Now just elevate that leg. You don't worry about gravity right now. Just elevating my leg. Good job. Watch. Claw on me. Other side. You're right here. Step on that foot. You get your hips out. Look, if I get this foot, elevate. Once my hips are out, I just elevate this foot. Okay? It's a little bit different than, you know, catching his wrist. Okay? You can be there, but I wouldn't even worry about it. If you're just trying, if you're just getting that reversal, making sure you guarantee you get out, then elevate that foot. Okay? You can turn into him here. Okay? When I have my claw on this side, so you were fighting claw here, and I went like this to you, boom, here. Okay, so you did a good job, you went to the post side, you went to this side, here. Okay, you didn't, don't worry about that. Hip post, there you go. Step on my foot, good. Hips out, hips come out. Catch the outside of my toe. See how extended you were, like this? I'm gonna pull you back, don't be extended, so you're here. Okay, yeah, there. Now you have the foot. Now I'm in trouble. Now I don't have options. So I'm gonna go this way, I'm probably gonna let go. Go this way. You're gonna have to elevate that thing so that when you turn, you're in position to score. Okay. So when you let go, you're in position to score. So I let go. Okay. Here, guide cross reaches and peels. I'm probably gonna come back here, forward, get to this side, okay? One of the main things you can do is just not let me in the first place. So, jump on top of me. Okay, guide here, okay? Right away, I'm already going, you know, kind of cracking down there, making sure, you know, you don't have great position to score. Also, another thing I can do, like an elevator, where as soon as you go into go claw, okay, so come back, get set. As soon as you go to go claw, I move that hand out, okay. Now, all I'm gonna do is elevate the inside of this foot here, okay, and get a reversal. Okay, let's go over that real quick. So we're here, okay, when you feel that claw coming in, okay, I just move my hand out of the way a little bit, begin to tuck my hip under. Now a lot of people think like, oh, well, that's gonna be a tight race. Don't worry about this, okay? What's gonna happen is as you're scooting your hip, okay, you're gonna elevate him here, okay? And what I wanna do is, if I can, come inside the leg. Here, just like a switch, okay? But a lot of times, just the pressure alone, he's gonna put him into this position, okay? Where you can come in on top and finish. So this is kind of a tricky one. It's called an elevator, but it's a good move to do. Like, if you found, like, no matter what happens, every time I claw you, you get rid of it, I claw you again, then all you gotta do is you're gonna move. As soon as you feel that claw coming in here, you're gonna take this hand back. So you feel the claw coming in like this, you're gonna take this hand, you're gonna move it over here, and move your body forward a little bit. Here, see how it's short, instead of being full. So get set, okay? Here, boom, right there. Okay, from this position, turn your hip down, flip inside my foot, my knee, right there, okay? And you're gonna elevate with your foot. There. To the reversal. Here.
just boom.
Okay. Now you feel like it's tight waist. So as soon as I get to your tight waist, you gotta make sure that's pinched so that you can hook in here. So that you can elevate. You start falling my head here. Yep. And now you come inside the leg here and squirt. Okay. We'll try that one. We'll see. Okay, good. See, even right here, you're in position to do the exact same thing. Only difference is now I have your hips. So pop your hips out. There. Now you're in a match now, okay? Does this make sense?
Yeah.
Have you seen this before?
Not exactly this one.
And another way people do it is when the guy goes chop, he goes to boom. Just a second. You know what I mean?
Yeah.